Shalom, everybody. Bobby Wilson here. Love to you there. How you doing? Listen, I woke up this morning. I could see, I could hear, taste, smell, walk, and talk. Thank you, God. And above all, most of all, I have received the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior. That means I have eternal security. Here's the deal. We are a spirit. We live in a body. We have a soul. That's salvation. Even if you live to be 120, the body will die one day. But Jesus Christ has prepared us for eternal salvation with Him. I mean, we're going to spend eternity in heaven with the Lord or in hell. I know in today's culture, you don't hear much about heaven and hell. But listen, if you read the Bible, the Holy Bible, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, said it's appointed unto man once to die and then the judgment. So after this body dies, our spirit, our soul, we're going to spend eternity somewhere. Listen, that's why it's so important to read the Bible, understand who you are. Understand who you are. In fact, I want to talk about you. Capital Y-O-U. I want to talk about you. And whatever situation, whatever circumstance you're facing, if you woke up this morning, you can see, you can hear, you can taste and smell, you can walk and talk, and you have received the Lord Jesus Christ, that's a good reason alone just to be thankful and grateful. I am. And listen, if you're experiencing sickness in your body, unfavorable circumstances, you have needs, I don't know whatever situation you're in, that maybe you're depressed or you feel stressed out or you felt left out. You know, people can have a tendency of looking over us. Rejection, mental illness, you name it. There's so many things we face in this life. But I'm here to be a witness that by putting your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, you plus God equal a majority. Listen, no need to hang your head down low. Lift up your head, okay? God loves you, and for whatever reason, it might, who knows? I love you. That second, what you want to know is the Heavenly Father, He loves you. In fact, He made you in His image and in His likeness. If you don't believe that, read the book of Genesis in the Holy Bible. The Holy Bible. I encourage you to read the Bible, the Holy Bible. Read the book of Genesis. It tells you about creation, how God made the heavens and the earth, the sun and the moon. I know some people don't believe that. I do. This is faith, believing the word of God. By faith, we believe the word of God. I want to talk about you. Yes, well, it's little old you or big old you. I want to talk about you. So once again, in the book of Genesis, you and I were made in the image of God and His likeness. So don't kill yourself. Don't commit suicide. Don't cut yourself. Don't abuse yourself by drinking drinks, eating foods, and smoking things that damage your body. Stop it. Don't you commit suicide. You're too valuable. When you were created, you've been made in the image of God and His likeness. Yes, you. Big old you or little old you. You are somebody in the eyes of God. And whoever I'm speaking to today, I'm encouraging you. Don't commit suicide. Don't kill nobody. It doesn't solve any problems at all. In fact, you took someone's life or you took your own life, that does not solve the problem at all. In fact, it could create problems for other families, especially if you kill somebody. Stop it and stop thinking about taking your own life. You are valuable. Bobby Wilson here to tell you that you are valuable. You have gifts and talents put into you by God. Listen, you are valuable. You are somebody. That's why it's so important for you and I to read the Bible and find out the great plan God has for you and I. He has a plan. Oh my, if you flow with God, now that's a real flow. I know there's other flows we can look at, like cars, houses, boats, money, you name it, food, traveling, you know, people flow that way, think that's all it is. No, no, no. God, the Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father, the creator of the heavens and earth. But like I said, I want to talk about you. Y-O-U. You're here for a reason, not an accident. Oh no, you're here for a reason. Another reason to read God's word, the Bible, so you can find out, so we can find out who we are, what his purpose is for us on this earth. There's a purpose for your life. People hurt us. Things don't go right. You know, you feel downtrodden. You feel forgotten about. You feel like I have no friends. I can't trust anybody. Hey, you are not alone. We are in this together. So I wanted to encourage you to find out who you are, your purpose in life. It's in the Word of God. Yes, yes, we go to school. Nothing wrong with that. You know, high school, we graduate, you know, and we go to college, get your degrees. Fine. I support that 100%. After that, you still need God to direct your paths. I want to talk about the Holy Ghost. Some of you, Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit? Yes, 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 yes. That's why it's important for you to read the Word of God, so you'll know what I'm talking about. Listen, y'all, we're not here by accident. You're not here by accident. God has a gift for us, and it is the Holy Ghost. He has a gift for everyone who will receive his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. You read in the Old Testament, the Spirit of God was upon men and women. But in the New Testament, he puts his Spirit in us. So if you're sick, if you're mentally ill, you're stressed out, you're confused, you don't know what to do, you feel hurt, left alone, you know, someone deceived you, they stole something from you. Hey, that F word, oh yeah, the F word, forgiveness. Walk in forgiveness. Just forgive them. Just you, just whether they ask you to forgive them or not, whether just in you forgive them, that sets you free, okay? All right, just forgive. Walk in forgiveness. God has forgiven us. Oh, yeah. So we should forgive others no matter what the circumstance is, no matter what the situation is. Walk in forgiveness. That F word. Forgive. Walk in forgiveness. And the L word, love. Walk in love. But back to you, who you are. Listen, we are a spirit. We live in a body, we have a soul, and time after time, our soul makes up our five senses. I give you one of them, our eyesight, that's one of our senses. That's a hint. What are the other five senses you have? What are the other four? We have to give an accountable to God what we do in this body. He's looking for us to obey him. You never heard about God? You never heard about the Bible? Listen, no more excuses after today. I'm telling you, read the Holy Bible, the best-selling book of all time. the Word of God, the Holy Bible, back to who you are. And I want to speak to you specifically. Don't commit suicide. Don't take your life. It doesn't solve any problems at all. Don't take your life. Don't commit suicide. Please do not do that. And please don't kill somebody else. That doesn't solve a problem either. Okay? I'm here to encourage you. But listen, God made you in His image and in His likeness. You are somebody. When you read the Word of God, the Bible, and find out who God is, who created the heavens and the earth, everything we see around us, God created. He used man to develop things and create things. But ultimately, it's God the Creator. And He has a purpose for your life. Don't you commit suicide. And I don't care what the anger, frustration. You know, sometimes we respond to things on impulse. They hurt me. I'm going to get them back. I'm just going to go shoot them and kill them. That don't work. Really, it doesn't solve a problem at all. Hey, listen, it doesn't solve a problem. Don't you take your life. That's a reason why the Lord told me to take a few minutes and just share with you. It's just something I just had to say. Hey, tell somebody, do not commit suicide. And don't take something could jeopardize your life. Don't ingest some type of drinks, drugs, whatever. Stop it. Stop it. Hey, God's got better for you. I once said better. Better. God's got better for you. Oh, I could hang my hat and say good night, everybody. Have a great day. Listen, if you don't remember anything else I said today, because of the Word of God, God has left His word for us, the Holy Bible, to live our lives according to His word. He's got better for you. Even if you don't have a job, maybe you don't make a lot of money or as much money as you think you should make, God has better for you. Keep His commandments. Walk in love. God has better for you. That sound like a song? Anybody listening in? Come on, let's write this song. God's got better for you. God's got better for me. Come on, musicians, let's hook up. Let's get together. Let's finish this song. God's got better. God's got better for you. God's got better for me. Okay, give me some more lyrics, okay? And let's get one of those slamming drum beats, okay? And some organ, piano, horns, trumpet, violins. Let's do it, y'all. It's time. The time is now, 2023. Listen. Now is the time. Stop what you're doing. Think about what you're doing. What are you doing creatively for your family, for yourself, and for your children? The best thing you can do, listen, is point them to the Word of God. Teach them the values, the promises, the principles, the commandments of our Heavenly Father. The time is now. God's got better for you. God's got better for me. God's got better for you. I want to hear from somebody. We got to finish writing this song together. Today, listen, you are somebody. You are loved. You are special. Special you. Guess what? Nobody else have the fingerprints like yours. Nobody. Nobody in there's over 8 billion people on this planet. Nobody has a fingerprint like yours. You're the only one that has a fingerprint like yours. Your footprint, the same deal. When you were born, one thing they got was your footprint as a baby. And later on in life, they got your fingerprint from somewhere. Okay, we won't go there. Your smile, your eyes, your personality, your gifts and talents. Only you can do what you can do. If you commit suicide, that's loss. Just what what you have in you can change somebody's life forever. Be kind to people. I know we live in a culture that seems like everybody's all in for themselves. Me, myself, I ain't caring about nobody else. Hey, but God wants us to be kind to people. Okay, so listen, I want to talk about you, the gifts and talents. You are special. You are special. Now, use your gifts and talents. Listen, things come against us, so we don't really realize everything God, the potential he has put in you. What things distract us? This flesh. This flesh wants to be pleased. Yes, this flesh wants to be pleased. Listen, there are all kind of things we can reach out to. Drinking stuff, smoking stuff, eating stuff, other activities. And it's designed just to please our flesh. Some of those things are not good for our bodies. They hurt the bodies. Okay, y'all know some of those things that's out there. You can drink, you can smoke, you can shoot. It only pleases the body. And some people do it because they feel hurt and, you know, problems in their lives. I understand that. I've been there. Hey, I wasn't born an angel, okay? For years and years, not lately though, but in my teens, as a boy, as a young man, with my friends, I did some of the very same, used some of the very same products. I'm telling you to be careful about drinking things, smoking things, shooting things in our body just to please this flesh. Or it causes you to make you feel better about yourself. Stop it. God's got better for you. Stop it. God's got better for you. Stop it. God's got better for you. He's got better. He's got better for you. As I mentioned, let's write this song. God's got better for me. God's got better for you. I hear a song coming up right now. Okay, Bobby Wilson told you that God's got better for you. Listen, I had some notes I want to share with you, but listen, I think God will be pleased if I get that across to you. You're special. You're so special. God loves you. I love you for whatever it means, but what you want to realize is our Heavenly Father God cares so much for you. He's made you and me in his image and in his likeness. Listen, tune out all those voices that's trying to distract you, telling you that you're nobody, or somebody just telling you something to make you feel good. You know, hey, all the negative voices we have in our ear today, the culture, politics, crime, sickness, disease, wars, rumors of wars, you name it. All those things, we're bombarded every day with so much information. Social media, TV, there's no good news ever, hardly, coming across social media or the TV. Listen, but there is good news. The gospel of Jesus Christ, his death, burial, and resurrection. Put your faith in the word of God. Put your faith in the word of God. God's got better for you. Okay, I'm adding to this song all of a sudden. God's got better for you. Put your faith in the word of God. God's got better for me. Put your faith in the word of God. God's got better for us. We put our faith in the word of God, the gospel of Jesus Christ. You, I'm talking to you. And listen, if you are already a Christian and have received Lord Jesus Christ, he's expecting you to be a disciple, and he's expecting you to win others. Be a witness of what God has done in your life. Listen, I love you. Listen, I've had some thoughts all over the place today. Excuse me. But I want to share with you that you're special. You're valuable. How many times do I have to say it? You're gifted. You're special. You can make a difference in your life and in somebody else's life. Listen, Bobby Wilson here. Love to you there. I'll talk to you next time, okay? Shalom.